All right, so this is a quick overview of the backend for Weebly websites. As you can see, they've divided their backend into build, where you're handling the layout, the text, the gallery, all the different features that you basically just drag, drop, move around. For each page, you select it as if you're browsing through the site, and then down here you can choose element, like choose a page layout, or drag and drop element. So if you want to have an image here, you basically just drag and drop. And one thing that I really like is that you see how it gives parameters for this image, and so it's going to drop it in the correct spot. It's not going to drop it like over here if you drop it over here, which is one advantage of Weebly over Wix. It sort of gives you parameters to customize your own website. At design, this is where you go and choose your custom themes. You can either design it, including by writing your own CSS, or you can go and select your own custom theme, which they have different options. You can basically take this as a foundation and go in and change it. Pages, this is where you go and manage your pages. I really like how they have advanced settings where you can customize the page title and page description for search results and for visitors arriving via search engines. You can also do footer and header codes per page. So if you want to run an A/B test, have a conversion code, have a retargeting code, you can do that. The only thing is that the way they have this, it can quickly get messy if you have more than, say, a dozen pages. It's certainly possible. It's just a little clunky to manage that many in the format they have it in. Store, and then their backend settings. And this is pretty straightforward. For a hosted website platform, it's pretty interesting that you can do 301 redirects. This is a advanced feature that a lot of times people don't realize they need until they really need it. Where you can set up multiple blogs, manage your store, and manage your members. So it's pretty intuitive. Actually, it's very intuitive compared to other self-hosted website builders. But the biggest concern, as with all self-hosted website builders, is that if you're ever interested in moving platforms, you have to basically download a archive of your website, which does not include any blog content, and it's just the content off your pages. To read more about the pros and cons and considerations, check out the full review in the video description.